Hi friends, good morning. Myself Sunil Vidoshi, lecturer in Applied Mechanics, Government Polytechnic, Ahmedabad. In Applied Mechanics subject, coplanar non-concurrent forces, today we learn how to solve numericals to find resultant of coplanar non-concurrent forces. So first of all, we have studied how to find resultant of coplanar non-concurrent forces in the last lecture. So recall all the steps. So first of all, you have to find magnitude of the resultant force, then find direction of the resultant force, then find position of the resultant force. So first of all, find out magnitude of the resultant force. So first step is resolve all the forces in x direction and y direction. Then find out sigma effect. Sigma effect means algebraic sum of components of all the forces in x direction. Then find out sigma fi. Sigma fi means algebraic sum of components of all forces in y direction. Then find out magnitude of the resultant force by using the formula r equal to square root of sigma fx square plus sigma fi square. Then find out direction of the resultant force. So find direction of the resultant force with respect to x-axis by using the relationship tan alpha equal to sigma fi upon sigma fi. Then you will get angle of the resultant force alpha equal to tan inverse sigma fi upon sigma fi. And depending upon the sign of sigma fx and sigma fi, decide in which quadrant the resultant lies. Then find out position of the resultant force. So to find position or location of the resultant, so first step is to obtain algebraic sum of moment of all the forces about any given point, say A. So find out sigma mf, means algebraic sum of all the moments of the forces about point A. So then find position of the resultant force such that it produces the same direction of the moment about the given point, say A. Apply Verignon's theorem to find position of the resultant force by using the formula sigma mf equal to r into d. R into d is the moment of the resultant force, where d is the perpendicular distance of the resultant force from the point A. Then find out x intercept of the resultant force, x equal to sigma mf upon sigma fi. Then find out y intercept of the resultant force, y equal to sigma mf upon sigma fx. So see this figure. So this is resultant force. This is resultant force. It is acting in this direction. Angle of resultant is this, and this is x intercept of the resultant force. This is perpendicular distance of the resultant force d, and this is y intercept of the resultant force. Then you will get the position of the resultant force. Then solve some examples. So first example is find magnitude, direction and position of resultant force for a given system of forces on a body. So forces are given in the figure. So the five forces are acting here. So and each block is of 1 meter by 1 meter, means this block is 1 by 1. 1 meter is this and 1 meter is this. So total distance is 3 meter. Here total vertical distance is 3 meter. So five forces are acting in this example. So first of all, resolve all the forces in x direction and y direction. So first of all, to find magnitude of the resultant force, resolve inclined force. Suppose inclination of the inclined force is not given, then assume this angle is as theta. Then find out tan theta equal to this side, opposite side 1, and adjacent side is 1, therefore 1 into 1 upon 1, then you will get the answer tan theta equal to 1. Then theta equal to tan inverse 1, then you will get the angle of inclination theta equal to 45. This is the angle of inclination of the force, 50 newton, that theta equal to 45 degree. Then resolve this force in x direction and in y direction. In x direction, resolution of this force is 50 cos 45, and resolution of this force in y direction is 50 sin 45. Then you will get the answer 50 cos 45 equal to 35.35, and in vertical direction 50 sine 45 equal to 35.35. Then consider right side forces as positive, left side forces as negative, upward forces as positive, downward forces as negative, clockwise moment as positive, anti-clockwise moment as negative. Then algebraic sum of all the forces in horizontal direction you have to find out. So that is sigma fx. Sigma means algebraic sum of all the forces in horizontal direction. Therefore, we have to take this force in this force and this force. This force is in left direction, therefore consider as minus. This force is in right direction, therefore consider as plus. This force is in right direction, therefore consider as plus. So algebraic sum of these forces is known as sigma fx. Sigma fx equal to 60 plus 35.35 minus this force 40, then you will get the sigma fx. So sigma fx equal to 65.35 newton. Then find out sigma fi. Sigma fi means algebraic sum of all the forces in y direction. So the vertical forces we have to take. So vertical, this force 40 newton, it is in upward direction, therefore considered as positive. This force is in upward direction, it is considered as positive. This force is in downward direction, therefore it is considered as negative. So algebraic sum of all these three forces is equal to sigma fi. Sigma fi is 40 plus 35.35 minus 15, then you will get sigma fi. So sigma fi is 60.35 newton. Then find out magnitude of the result moment by using this formula, r equal to square root of sigma fx square plus sigma fi square. So put the value of sigma fx and sigma fi, then you will get the answer. So sigma fx is 65.35 and sigma fi is 60.35. So put the value of the sigma fx and sigma fi, then you will get the answer. So magnitude of the resultant force is 88.95 newton. Then find out direction of the resultant force. So to find direction of the resultant, we have to apply the formula. Tan alpha equal to sigma fi upon sigma fx. Then alpha equal to tan inverse sigma fi upon sigma fx. Then put the value of sigma fi and sigma fx, they will get the angle of resultant force with respect to x-axis. So alpha equal to tan inverse sigma fi upon sigma, put the value of sigma fi and sigma fx. So alpha equal to tan inverse 60.35 upon 65.35, then you will get the answer. Alpha is 42.72 degrees. So this is the inclination of the resultant force with respect to x-axis. So as we know that sigma fx is positive and sigma fi is positive, therefore resultant lies in first quadrant. Then find out position of the resultant force. So to find position of the resultant force, we have to take moment of all the forces about point O. So this is point O. This is point O. So we have to take moment of all these forces. If I consider this force 30 newton, so the moment of this force is in anticlockwise direction, therefore it is considered as negative. So moment of this force is 30 plus into perpendicular distance is 2 meters. So 30 into 2, then you will get the moment of this force. Then consider this force 40 newton, and moment of this force 40 newton is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider it as negative. So 40 into this perpendicular distance, 40 into 1, so 40 into 1, then you will get the moment of this force. Then find out moment of this force 50 sine 45 equal to 35.35. So 35.35 into perpendicular distance from this point is, from point O, is 2 meters. So 35.35 into 2, it is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider as negative. This moment is in clockwise direction, therefore consider as positive. So 35.35 into this distance 2 meters, then you will get the moment of this force. Then find out moment of this force 60 newton, it is in clockwise direction, therefore consider as positive. So 60 into this distance 1 meter, then you will get the answer of this moment. Then find, take moment of this force, it is in clockwise direction, therefore consider as positive. So 15 into 2, then you will get the moment of this force. Then take algebraic sum of all the moment of all the forces, then you will get sigma MFO. Sigma MFO equal to 15 into 2. So 15 15 into 2. So you will get the moment of this force. Then take moment of this force 60 into 1. Then you will get the moment of this force. It is in clockwise direction, therefore considered as positive. It is also in clockwise direction, therefore considered as positive. Then find out moment of this force 35.35 into 2. It is also in clockwise direction, therefore considered as positive. It is in anticlockwise direction, therefore 35.35 into 2. Then you will get the moment here. Then minus 40 into 1, minus this force 40 into distance from point A is 1 meter. So 40 into 1, then you will get the moment about point A. It is in anticlockwise direction, therefore considered as negative. Then take this force, moment is anticlockwise, therefore consider it as negative. So 30 into this distance 2, then you will get the moment. Then take algebraic sum of all this, then you will get moment of all the forces about point O. So MFO equal to minus 10 newton into meter. Since minus 10 means moment is in anticlockwise direction. So therefore moment of resultant is also in anticlockwise direction. So apply Varick law's theorem. So minus R into D equal to sigma MFO. So put the value of R and sigma MFO. So D equal to 10 upon 88.95. You will get the perpendicular distance of the resultant force with respect to point O. D equal to 0.11 meter. Then find out X intercept of the resultant force. X intercept of the resultant force is sigma MFA. MFO upon sigma FI. So put the value of sigma MF 10 upon sigma FI. Put the value of sigma FI is 60.6035. Then you get the answer 0.65 meter. Then find out y intercept of the resultant force. Y intercept is sigma MF upon sigma X. So put the value of sigma MF 10 and sigma FX is 65.35. Then you will get the answer 0.65. So in this figure, you can see that this is the resultant force. It is in first quadrant. It is and angle of resultant with the horizontal axis is 42.70. This is the perpendicular distance of the resultant force, and this is x intercept is 0.16 meter, and y intercept is 0.15 meter. So you look at this resultant force. Then take another example. So in this example, four forces are acting tangentially to a circle of radius 2 meter as shown in figure. Determine the resultant in magnitude and its direction and location with respect to the center of the circle. So four forces are acting here, as shown in figure. So 70 newton is in downward direction, 120 newton is in the right direction, 40 newton in upward direction, and 80 newton at an angle of 45 degree. So first of all, resolve this inclined force 80 newton. So to find magnitude of the resultant force, first of all resolve this force, inclined force, in horizontal direction and vertical direction. So angle is 45 degree. So you will get horizontal component is 80 cos 45. And the vertical component is 80 sin 45. So 80 cos 45 equal to 56.56, 80 sin 45 equal to 56.56 newton. So then consider right side forces as positive, left side forces as negative, upward forces as positive, downward forces as negative, clockwise moment as positive, anti-clockwise moment as negative. Then find out algebraic sum of all the forces in horizontal direction, means x direction. So then find out sigma fx. So sigma fx means algebraic sum of all the forces in horizontal direction. So this force is considered as positive because it is acting in right direction. This force is acting in left direction, therefore it is considered as negative. So this 120 minus this 56.6, then you will get sigma fx. Sigma fx equal to 63.44 newton. Then find out sigma fi. Sigma fi means algebraic sum of all the forces in vertical direction. So this force is in upward direction, therefore considered as positive. This force is in downward direction, therefore considered as negative. This force is in downward direction, therefore considered as negative. So 40 minus 70 minus 56.56, they will get sigma Fi. Sigma Fi equal to minus 86.56 Newton. Then by using the formula, you will get magnitude of the resultant force, R equal to square root of sigma Fx square plus sigma Fy square. So put the value of sigma Fx and sigma Fy, so you will get the answer of magnitude of the resultant force. So sigma Fx is 63.44 and sigma Fy is 86.56. So put the value of sigma Fx and sigma Fy in this equation. So you will get the answer of magnitude of the resultant force. So magnitude of the resultant force R equal to 107.31 Newton. Then find magnitude, then find direction of the resultant force. So so direction of the resultant force with respect to x-axis is, suppose alpha, so alpha equal to 10 inverse sigma Fi upon sigma Fx. Then put the value of sigma Fi and sigma Fx in this equation, so we will get the angle of resultant force with respect to x-axis. So alpha equal to 10 inverse sigma Fi upon sigma Fx. Put the value of sigma Fi, Fi is 86.56. Then put the value of sigma Fx, Fx is 63.44, then you will get the angle of resultant force with respect to x, alpha equal to 53.76 degree. Then find out position of the resultant force. So to find position of the, we have to take moment of all the forces. So moment of this force 70 Newton, we have to take moment at the center. So this distance is 3 meter. So 70 into 3. So you will get the moment of this force. This is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider as negative. So take this force 120 Newton and perpendicular resistance of this force from the center. So you will get the moment of this force. It is in clockwise direction, therefore consider as positive. So consider this force, this moment is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider as negative. So 40 into this distance, so you will get the moment of this distance. Then take this force, it is in clockwise direction, therefore consider as it is positive. So 80 and into this distance. So you will get the moment of this force. Then take algebraic sum of all the moment of all the forces. So sigma MFO equal to 120 into 2. So 120 is the force and 2 is the perpendicular distance from the center. So 120, it is in clockwise direction, therefore consider it as positive. Then take 40 Newton force. So 40 Newton moment is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider it as negative. So minus 40 into this distance 2 meter. So you will get the moment of this force. Then take this force 80 Newton. So force is 80 Newton and perpendicular distance is 2 meter. The moment is in clockwise direction, therefore it is considered as positive. So positive 80 into 2. The moment of this force is in anticlockwise direction, so it is considered as negative. So 70 into this distance 2 meter. So 70 into 2. Then you will get the algebraic sum of all the moment of all the forces. So sigma MFO equal to this 120 Newton. As the sigma MFO is positive, so moment of resultant is also positive. So apply Verignon's theorem of moment. So moment of resultant R into D equal to sigma MFO. So put the value of sigma MFO and put the value of R. So you will get the perpendicular distance of the resultant force. So D equal to 180 upon 107.34. So you will get the perpendicular distance D equal to 1.677 meter. Then find out x-intercept of the resultant force. X-intercept of the resultant force equal to sigma MFO upon sigma Fi. Then put the value of sigma MFO and put the value of sigma Fi. So you will get the answer. X-intercept equal to 2.08 meter. Then find out y-intercept of the resultant force. Y intercept equal to sigma MF upon sigma Fx. So put the value of sigma MF and sigma Fx, you will get Y intercept of the resultant force 2.837 meter. So then take Another example, calculate magnitude, direction and position of the resultant force for the four systems shown in figure. So four forces are given in the figure, so we have to find magnitude, direction and position of the resultant force. So in this figure, these two forces are inclined forces, so we have to take component of these forces. So consider this force, 4 kilonewton, angle is not given, so assume this angle as theta 1, so find out theta 1 angle, so by using this formula, 10 theta 1 equal to this side 1 and this side is 2, so 1 upon 2, so you will get 10 theta 1, 10 theta 1 equal to 1 by 2 equal to 0.5, then theta 1 equal to 10 inverse 0.5, then you will get angle theta 1, theta 1 equal to 26.56 degree. Then assume this angle as theta 2, so theta 2 equal to this side is 3 meter, this side is 2 meter, so theta 2 equal to 3 by 2 means 1.5, so theta 2 equal to 10 inverse 1.5, so you will get angle theta 2 equal to 56.3 degree. Then resolve this force in horizontal direction and in vertical direction. So horizontal component is 4 cos theta 1, so 4 cos 26.56, so you will get horizontal component 3.578 kilonewton. Then find out vertical component. So vertical component is 4 sin 26.56, its answer is 1.788 kilonewton. Then find out original component of this force. So the original component of this force is 2 kilonewton. So 2 cos theta 2. So theta 2 is 56.3 degree. So 2 cos 56.3 degree is 3.3309 kilonewton. Then find out vertical component of this force is 2 sin theta 2. So theta 2 is 56.3 degree. So 2 sin 56.3, they will get vertical component equal to 1.664 kilonewton. So then consider right side forces as positive, left side forces as negative, upward forces as positive, downward forces as negative, clockwise moment as positive, anti-clockwise moment as negative. Then find sigma fx. Sigma fx means algebraic sum of components of all the forces in x direction. So this force is in left direction, therefore it is considered as positive, negative. This force is in right direction, therefore consider it as positive. This force is in left direction, therefore consider it as negative. So then find out sigma fx. So sigma fx equal to 3.578 means this force is in right direction, therefore it is considered as positive. Then minus 1.109 means this force horizontal component of the this, so this is in left direction, therefore it is considered as negative. This is also negative 6 kilonewton minus 6, so you will get sigma fx equal to minus 3.531 kilonewton. Then find out sigma fy, we have to take vertical component of the forces. So consider this force and consider this force, then you will get sigma fy. These two forces are in upward direction, therefore consider as positive. This force is in downward direction, therefore consider it as negative. Then you will get sigma fy. So sigma fy equal to 3 plus 1.788 minus this 1.664, so you will get sigma fy equal to 3.124 kilonewton. Then find out magnitude of the resultant force, R equal to square root of sigma fx square plus sigma fy square. So put the value of sigma fy and sigma fx, so you will get magnitude of the resultant force. So magnitude of the resultant force, R equal to 4.714 kilonewton. Then find out direction of the resultant force. So the direction of the resultant force, so to find direction of the resultant force, we have apply the alpha equal to 10 inverse sigma fi upon sigma fi. This is the equation to find direction of the resultant force. So put the value of sigma fi and sigma fx. So you will get angle of the resultant force with respect to x axis. So alpha is equal to 41.5 degree. As we know that sigma fx is negative and sigma fi is positive in this case. So resultant lies in second quadrant. Then find out position of the resultant force. So to find position of the resultant force, we have to take moment of all the forces. Consider clockwise moment as positive and anti-clockwise moment as negative, and take moment about point O, this point O, of this is O. Consider clockwise as positive, anti-clockwise as negative. So the moment of this force is in anti-clockwise direction, therefore considered as negative. The moment of this force is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider it as negative. Moment of this force is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider it as negative. Moment of this force is in clockwise direction, therefore consider it as positive. Moment of this force is in clockwise direction, therefore consider it as positive. So to take moment of this all the forces, then we will get sigma MFO. So sigma MFO equal to 3.578. So this is 3.578, and per distance from point O, perpendicular distance of this from point O is 4 unit, means 1, 2, 3, 4. So 3.578 into 4, so you will get the moment of this 4. Then take this is in anticlockwise, therefore consider it as negative. So 1.788 into perpendicular distance 1 2 3 4, so 1.788 into 4, so you will get the moment of this force. Then take moment of this 1.109, it is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider it as negative, and distance is 3 meter, so 1.109 into 3, then you will get moment of this force. Then take this force 1.664, and perpendicular distance is 5, so 1.664 into 5, then you will get moment of this force. It is in clockwise direction, therefore consider it as positive. Then take moment of this force, it is in anticlockwise direction, therefore consider it as negative. So minus 6 into 3. Then take moment of this force 3. 3 into perpendicular distance is 1. So 3 into 1. It is in anticlockwise, therefore consider it as negative. Then you will get the sigma MF. So sigma MF equal to minus 8.847 kilonewton into meter. Then we know that sigma MF is negative, so moment of the resultant is also negative. Negative means anticlockwise direction. So apply Verignon's theorem. So then moment of the resultant R into D equal to sigma MFO. Put the value of sigma MFO and put the value of R, then you will get the answer. Perpendicular D equal to 1.876 meter. So D is the perpendicular distance of the resultant force with the. Then find out x-intercept of the resultant force. X-intercept of the resultant force is equal to sigma MFO upon sigma Fi. So put the value of sigma MF and sigma Fi. So you will get x-intercept of the resultant force, 2.83 meter. Then find out y-intercept of the resultant force. Y-intercept is sigma MF upon sigma Fx. So put the value of sigma MF and sigma Fx. Then you will get y-intercept of the resultant force is 2.5 meter. Then take this example. Take this example. So in this example, find magnitude and direction of the resultant force for the system of forces as shown in figure. So figure is given. Four forces are acting like this in a square of 3 by 3. So you have to find out magnitude and direction only. You have not found out direction of the. You have to find magnitude and direction of the resultant force only. You have not find the position of the resultant force. Only find out magnitude and direction of the, because it is given in the data. So you have to find out magnitude and direction of the resultant force only. So how to find magnitude and direction? We know there. So first of all, resolve all the forces in x direction and y direction. So resolution of this force in x direction and resolve this force in y direction. So angle is 30 degree. So to force into cos theta. So this force 25 into cos 30. So you will get the answer. The 25 into sin 30. Then you will get the answer. This is vertical vertical component of the force. This is vertical component of this force. Force is 20 kilonewton, angle is 60 degree. Their horizontal component is 20 cos 60 and vertical component is 20 sin 60. Then resolve this force in horizontal direction and vertical direction. So force is 15 kilonewton, so 15 cos 45, so you will get horizontal component, and 50 sin 45, so you will get vertical component. Then find out sigma fx. So to find sigma fx, consider right side forces are positive, left side forces are negative. So these four forces we have to take. This force is in right direction, therefore consider it positive. This force is in right direction, therefore consider it as positive. This force is in left direction, therefore consider it as negative. So 21.65 plus 10.6 minus 10, so you will get sigma fx. Sigma fx equal to 22.25 kilonewton. Then find out sigma fi. So to find sigma fi, we have to take vertical forces, this force, and this force. So these two forces are in upward direction, therefore consider it as positive. These two forces are in downward direction, therefore consider it as negative. So this force 12.5 plus 17.32 minus 12 minus 10.6, then you will get sigma fi. Sigma fi equal to 7.22 kilonewton. Then find out magnitude of the resultant force by using this formula. R equal to square root of sigma fx square plus sigma fi square. Put the value of sigma fx and sigma fi, then you will get magnitude of the resultant force. Magnitude of the resultant force, R equal to 23.39 kilonewton. Then find out direction of the resultant force. So direction of the resultant force, you have to apply the formula alpha equal to 10 inverse sigma fi upon sigma fx. So put the value of sigma fi and sigma fx, so you will get the answer. So 10 alpha equal to 10 inverse 7.22 upon 22.5. So this is the angle of resultant force with respect to x axis. So alpha equal to 17.79 degree. So as sigma fx is positive and sigma fi is positive, so resultant is in first quadrant. So in this lecture we have solved some examples of resultant of coplanar non-concurrent forces. Thank you.